said times in his rhymes, cause his memories. We running through New York, so you never leave. Strap my lungs, then we puffin' through with that, right? We're giving them some stories, they come back like manic this, manic that, why you crawling to me? The hell we gonna... Okay guys, welcome back to the channel. So if you're just finding this video, it's probably because it's the only one in relation to this engine. As you guys know, this engine does relate to a lot of the UK and EU guys. Nobody really knows this engine as well as me. I've owned quite a few of them. So we're gonna go over the M46 reliability video. And this is purely because I get asked a lot about this engine and many people don't even know about it or it even exists. And as you guys know, a lot of American guys, unless they know the engine, they can't do it because they don't know anything about it. So I'm gonna go over all the common problems on it and I'm gonna explain to you what fails and what you need to replace and why this engine is problematic. So as you'll know, the M46 engine was the first engine ever produced with Valvetronic. Valvetronic was BMW's first designless engine and it was plagued in issues. And you have to understand why. It's because BMW only just released it. It was gonna be plagued in issues because BMW was the first time they ever tested it. And it was just a problematic engine with a number of problems going wrong with it. So I'm gonna explain to you all the problems that you end up running through with this engine. So the first one will be the Valvetronic itself. Now the Valvetronic on them, bearing in mind BMW didn't really configure it correctly, what was happening on them engines, and a lot of people went up with Vanos codes, will be because of the eccentric shaft, as you'll see up here. Now the eccentric shaft sits under the valve cover. It's a common problem, and what ends up happening is the Valvetronic motor that's used to activate the eccentric shaft, and it's usually to obviously advance the timing and also reduce emissions and obviously make more power based on the valves. It would slip on the eccentric shaft and grind it all the time on the shaft itself. So on the teeth you get where the Valvetronic motor is meant to be, but it wasn't properly aligned on that engine. So what was happening is it was eating the hell out of the eccentric shaft itself on the teeth. So when that goes wrong, you end up with a rough idle, your car failing to start, sometimes cutting out, or sometimes when you're sitting in the car, you'll feel like a shunt, like you're being hit from behind. And that's because the Valvetronic motor is not disengaging properly. It can't come away from the eccentric shaft because, as you guys know, when you hit the brakes, the Valvetronic motor comes away and then goes back onto it when you're going into gear, advancing the timing. But that's not the case with the M46. The next one on them is the valve covers leaking, which is up here as well. The valve covers are notorious for leaking, and this is due to because of the Valvetronic system itself. When it ends up eating the eccentric shaft, it causes a lot of wear on the engine. People are trying to floor it where it's not getting as much power because they realize the power's down, and the valve covers end up leaking. It's a common problem on the M46. They always leak, and like I said, it usually leaks and you end up smelling the burning in the cabin. It's notorious for burning oil because of that problem, and it's an easy job that anyone can rectify at home. As you guys know, they don't use the high pressure injectors, so it's a straight out and straight fit for a new one. They're not expensive to buy, but like I said, when you take the valve cover off, you're more likely to find that the eccentric shaft is completely worn. So bear in mind before you take this valve cover off that you do go and buy a new one based on that, because you're going to probably find it worn. Your Valvetronic motors don't hardly fail. I've only seen a few in my time fail on them, and usually that's because people don't realize their eccentric shaft is knackered and they end up going to buy a Valvetronic motor thinking it's that, and then to find out the eccentric shaft was the one that was eating up, so it's literally binding and sliding off the eccentric shaft itself. The next one on these guys is going to be the valve stem seals. These engines are notorious for going through the valve stem seals. It was a design flaw by BMW when they released this engine alongside with the M52 B23 and the B25. They all suffered the issue with valve stem seals, and it's still the same on the M46. Now, as you guys know, the M46 was made in a lot of cars, 116i, 118i, 120i. They're all the same engine, just as I said, it was a different spec. They all come with the M46 engine, and that's the same with the 316i, 389, 320i. Now, the valve stem seals on them do fail and you have to get them redone. You can try and use the Forte seal conditioner. It has worked many, many times on them engines, but that's if you catch it immediately. What ends up happening is with these engines, a lot of people end up thinking it's the CCV blowing a blue smoke, and I will show you now, the CCV don't really rupture on the M46 engine. It's a massive job to do as well. It's not nothing like what you do on the M52. M46, it's right down the bottom and plugged onto the bottom, and all the hoses are very fiddly to get to as well and very hard to do. You can do it with the manifold on or just lifting it up, but it's not a simple job to do it. It takes a lot of time, and obviously connecting the hose onto the sump return pipe is quite fiddly in there, and obviously bolting up all the breather and everything else there is quite a fiddly job, and to do it blindfolded is not easy. And a lot of people end up thinking that's the main cause of their blue smoke, which is not. I assure you it's not. It's going to be your valve stem seals. They do stuff with it because of that eccentric shaft failing, which causes
in turn, your valve stem seals to fail. The next one I want to get onto, guys, is the valve solenoids. Now, this is a very, very overlooked problem on the M46. If they fail and you continue to drive on them, they will end up messing up the whole eccentric shaft system and also the whole Vanos system. My best recommendation is to have the whole Vanos system cleaned completely and have it fully rebuilt. Now, a garage don't usually charge much for this, and it's something you can do at home yourself. It's a very easy engine, and mechanically, you could do it yourself at home, which take the valve cover off and get the eccentric shaft out and redo the whole Vanos system itself and make sure it's all perfect. Because at the end of the day, the M46 engine is not a difficult engine. It's very small, it's a four-cylinder engine, and like I said, it is easy accessible. So therefore, I would advise you to try and clean your whole Vanos system and replace your Vanos solenoids. Don't think of cleaning them, because cleaning them is not going to work on this engine whatsoever, and they're cheap enough to go and buy. The next one on this car, guys, is the timing chain failure. As many of you guys know, timing chain is still a plagued issue on this engine as well, as the M47 and the N20s and all the other engine, M46 suffers with the same issue. Timing chain failure. Again, that's because the whole Vanos system is used on the chain. It causes too much wear on the chain, and the tensioner usually ends up giving up on it. So you have to replace the tensioner. If you're lucky enough, you might not have to replace your chain, but my best bit is if you're gonna replace it all, you're gonna open the valve covers to replace the chain, because they are known to go, and the tensioners are, and the guides are known to break on them engines. So I'd strongly advise you to replace the chain guides as well as the chain, just to be on the safe side, because you could be going down the street one day and then you have to be back in there. And also, you don't know how far gone is stretched, so I wouldn't take the chance of just replacing the tensioner and not checking about the chain either. Like I said, these are all jobs that can be done at home. If you're gonna take the valve cover, if you have access to the chain, the eccentric shaft, the lot. So it's something I recommend doing. It all sits on the front, it's not on the back of the engine on them. So it's something to be aware of that you can do at home. The next one on these, guys, that fails a lot on the M46, especially on the autos, this is not applied to the manuals, is the torque converter on them. The torque converter ends up running dry fluid where people just rag the crap out of them. And then what happens is when they give them onto the new owner, you don't realize it straight away. And I assure you, if you're gonna go and buy an M46, my best advice is to drive that around for a very long time until it gets up to temperature. When it gets up to temperature, we end up noticing that the oil becomes very thin and the torque converter ends up locking up in the engine, causing you again to shunt forward. And the gearbox feels like it's jumping all over the place and the idle start going all over the place where the torque converter is not disengaging from the engine. So what will end up happening, you'll see your idle going up and down while it's at speed, and you'll also feel a shunt, and it will keep shunting until you pull it back into park, into neutral, and back into drive. It's a continuous problem on these M46 engines, on the four-cylinder engines. The gearboxes do go out on them. So anyone who's planning to get an automatic one, I would advise you to make sure you do your checks if that's what you really want, or go for a manual, because they're going to be a lot more reliable than the autos. The autos did have a lot of issues like that. And it is not an expensive job, because it's a small engine, but it can end up being very, very expensive if you don't know what you're doing. Another thing that likes to fail on these, guys, is the ignition coils. Now, I will advise you straight away, do not go replacing them, because what ends up happening, when the valve stem seals go, or the valvetronic ain't working properly, what ends up happening, you go down on power. People instantly suggest replacing the ignition coils or the spark plugs. What ends up happening is the valve stem seals end up leaking oil past them into the chain, which end up coating the whole spark plugs to not fire properly, which in turn makes you believe you change the spark plugs and coils and your car's running perfect again. That's because they're not coated in oil. Usually, it's due to because your valve stem seals are leaking, so no changing the ignition coils or the spark plugs is gonna change that. So I would recommend checking your valve stem seals first, because usually that's a common cause, because you will go around replacing all of that only to find it was your valve stem seals causing the whole issue in the sense. Because what ends up happening is it puts too much stress on the spark plug where it can't burn the fuel, which in turn puts too much pressure on the ignition coils, which end up failing. And then you go and replace them, you think the car's all perfect again because it starts giving you full power again, because them spark plugs ain't coated and the ignition coils ain't having to work as hard, when in turn it's actually valve stem seals leaking in and causing your spark plugs to fail. So I'd recommend going to check for your valve stem seals before replacing your ignition coils or your spark plugs. Like I said, overall, the M46 can be reliable. A lot of people choose it because they think that they're gonna save on road tax and fuel, and because it's popular, because for insurance purposes. But my best advice is if you do want to go out and buy that, try and find one of those that's had all the work done, which majority of the time it won't. If you are planning to buy an air valve stem seals done, consider having money for that, because they do fail. Regardless of what the owner tells you, they will fail. It's a common issue on them, and they do. The same for the eccentric shaft. The Vanos system is very problematic on that. As I said, BMW's first valvetronic system, it's gonna have its failures. So I would strongly recommend that if you're gonna go and look for one, make sure it's had all that done, make sure you do your checks, make sure you drive it long enough to check for all these things as well, because they are a common issue and it can end up costing you massively, especially if you're not planning to do the work yourself. And most people who go and buy this engine and buy this car is because they can't do the work themselves. They want a small engine, which is gonna be cheap maintenance. But the valvetronic system on that is actually more expensive than the equivalent of other BMWs for the six cylinder, because the Valvetronic system on that is expensive because it always goes wrong, where on the six cylinders it don't. And that's why a lot of the guys are looking for parts to fit to the M46 that they can find from the six cylinders, which is nowhere to be found. And majority of the time, the parts for the M46 as well, they can't find because they're being so highly sourced for being problems with other M46s that there's no parts available to be fitted to any other cars. So guys, there you have it. This is the M46 reliability video. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Like I said, nobody's managed to do it because a lot of people don't know about this video, but these are the most common issues that do fail on this engine. If you have enjoyed this video and you haven't subscribed already, please go ahead and subscribe. Please like this video as well. This is BMW Dr. Dean here. Thank you very much for watching, and goodbye.